What's up, YouTube? About to get in here and hit an arm workout today. So hopefully you'll watch along with us and yeah, let's go blast some arms. It's one of my favorite things to do. Probably because you can see progress early on. And I think that's important when you're in a fitness journey. You want to be able to see progress, you know, not 6 months from now, but you know, not 4 months from now. But you know, you really get in and you blast arms for a few weeks and you kind of start noticing progress in your arms. So let's get in here, blast out some arms. We're going to do biceps today, triceps, and we're going to work forearms. So yeah, let's get going. All right guys, so we're inside the gym, about to knock out an arm workout. The first thing we're going to start with is our biceps. I'm going to do, for lack of a better term, what I call jailhouse curls. Because in any movie or TV show where they go into a prison yard, you see somebody doing these. They're a good way to get the blood pumping, get the blood flowing. And when you're first starting out on these, I'd recommend going pretty lightweight. You'll see why if you start doing them. It's just about getting the form. You want it to stay strict. You want to keep your body tight and not be rocking. You know, you'll see a lot of people rocking. I hope that doesn't make you sick with me doing that with the camera. But and I may, you know, have a little bit of motion at the end of each set, but the point is to try to stay as strict as possible and just use your biceps, concentrate to get that weight up. So yeah, we're gonna start out with a set of 10 and you'll see what I'm talking about. All right. Okay, so as you might have noticed, I struggled with that set. I only got 8. So what I'm going to do now, and it's something you can do too, is we're going to drop down 5 pounds on each side. So we'll just pull our 10s off, put 5s on there, and we should be able to knock that out for 10, no problem. The other thing is, when doing arms like this, make sure you're getting your rest, because you need it. A minute and a half to 2 minutes between each set. So yeah, we're gonna drop weight a little bit, try to finish up 10, and move on. Alright guys, so the next exercise we're going to do is dumbbell hammer curls. The reason it's called a hammer curl is because it's going to be kind of this motion, like you're hammering. You really want to try to limit your body swing, but on this exercise, some is acceptable. What I mean is, you know, if you have to kind of twist to get it up, that's okay. You don't want to be doing this motion, but, you know, if you need a little bit of help to get it up, get it up. We're gonna start pretty light. I'm gonna start at about 30 pounds. In case you haven't noticed, I'm wearing something on my arm for the last couple of videos. I hurt my elbow last week. Well, it's been a little bit longer than a week on arm day. So mostly it hurts when I'm doing tricep exercises, but we'll see how it goes with the bicep stuff. And hopefully we can at least put out a decent video, even if the weight's not all that impressive. So, all right, let's do some hammer curls and we'll get it going. Okay, so that didn't feel too bad. How'd that feel for you guys? it's a nice exercise. I like doing it. It really helps build, you know, overall mass to the arms. And I wasn't flexing to show you I have massive arms. I was just showing what part you're working out. That's where your bicep is, in case you were unaware. But so yeah, that's the best way to put mass on. Now, that won't give you cuts. That's not gonna make your arm all chiseled doing this particular exercise, but we'll do a burnout here in a little bit, and that'll help burn excess fat around the biceps, and then we'll go to triceps. All right, let's knock out another set. Alright guys, so we just knocked out three really good sets of 10 each. So we did 30s, 35s, and 40s, and it felt pretty good. Felt good with my arm. So yeah, felt pretty good. Could have probably went even a little bit heavier, but you know, we're already getting injuries. So like I told you in the last few videos, we got to keep it safe. And just know that we got to do this for a long time, especially if you're, you know, this size. This isn't something you're gonna be able to fix on a 6-week challenge or something. So we just do little increments each time and go up a little bit of weight when we feel it, and we don't, we go back down weight like we did on the other exercise and finish out our sets. So already sweating, not sure if that's just because it's really hot or I'm getting in a really good workout. I can't tell yet, but yeah, so let's get to it and get to the next exercise. All right guys, we're over at the preacher curl machine. The reason they call it a preacher curl machine is kind of like the old Catholic priest getting down to pray. That's kind of what you're doing. It's a bicep exercise. Now the thing on these is you want to make sure your arms are firmly planted on the pad. Make sure the seat's low enough. If the seat's too high, you can hurt your elbow and hurt your forearm and some other stuff. So make sure the seat's low enough to where you're really just isolating your bicep. Also check the weight. I just, you know, from the last person, I just sat down, went to pull one up just for a little warm up, and it was sitting on 100 pounds, so I was, yeah. But we're gonna do, we're trying to, you know, really burn on this one, so we're gonna drop the weight down significantly. We'll probably drop it down to maybe 30 pounds, try to do 20 reps with that, and then my goal is to get 3 sets of 20 reps, so. We really want to see where we're at and see how it feels after the first one. If that's just way too little weight, then we'll bump it up. If we're getting a good burn on that 15 to 20, we may just leave the weight exactly where it's at and just focus on the volume. So yeah, let's do it. All right, so we didn't feel a ton of burn on that. You know, 19 and 20, 20th rep, we were feeling a little bit. I was feeling a little bit, so I think I'm gonna jump up the weight and shoot for another 20. There it was. Felt the burn. Starting at about 14. So, probably just gonna leave the weight where it's at. It's at 40 right now, and shoot for another set of 20. Over the top, Stallone. That was a good one. All right, guys, so the next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna try to do what they call reverse curls. The reason it's called a reverse curl is because the grip, okay? So you've noticed everything we've done, we've been gripping like this, right? Towards our face, both hands. This grip is like this, okay? And what that really focuses on is it really focuses on the forearm, okay? So we're gonna be doing it from here to here. Okay, both hands like this. Okay, it will work your bicep, but it's definitely gonna work your forearm as well. Probably more your forearm than your bicep at this point. You gotta start light with this because it's a forearm exercise. I'm just gonna be using a standard Olympic bar, which is 45 pounds to start. I'll probably do two sets, but I'm probably not gonna add hardly any weight, maybe 5 pounds, maybe 10 pounds. Because it's for your forearms. Yeah, it's a reverse curl, but it's for your forearms. So, all right, guys, let's get going on this. Alright, guys, so I don't know if you can tell, but you want to keep your elbows in, tucked into your body when you're doing that. It's something I forgot to mention. You don't want to go real wide with it. That's, you know, it will work your forearms too, but it puts strain on the elbows. So you want to keep your elbows tucked in. You're a big guy like me, that's hard. You'll hear lots of people saying, oh, always tuck your elbows in on everything you're doing. You know, my elbows are still 3 feet apart from each other, so that may be the case for you as well. But keep them tucked into your body as best you can. As you can see, mine are still going at this angle, even though they're tucked in. That's as close as they come. So that'll change as the midsection gets thinner. But yeah, keep your arms tucked in. Like I said, I'm gonna put a little bit of weight on here, not much. And you know, you really start feeling it in your forearms. I mean, even, you know, just that amount of exercise, I can already really feel a burn right there. So let's put on some weight and do another set. Alright, guys, so as you can see, adding just a little bit of weight really makes a big difference. I was only able to get, I think, 8 or 9 on that by putting a 10-pound plate on each side. So again, because it's mostly your forearm movement, okay? Yeah, like I said, a little bit of biceps, and my biceps are tired from everything we've been doing, but it's mostly focusing on your forearms. The next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna leave that weight on there. It's not much weight. We're gonna go into another forearm exercise. Now, it looks really strange, and I know it looks strange. And the range of motion, I'm gonna back up a little bit. I don't know if you can see. It's probably too far. But the range of motion is probably 3 inches. It's this movement, okay? But the way you're gonna put the weight on, you're gonna use your shoulders and your back to really support it. It's gonna be behind your back, and you're just gonna pull up. So you'll really feel it in your forearms. Even if you just place your arms down by your side. Do that motion. You're going to be doing this motion behind your back. You can really feel that tense up. So I'm hoping I can get a good camera shot of this. It is a weird motion. It feels weird when you do it, especially if you're a bigger guy, because your arms are kind of more back, because you have a larger backside like I do, then they would standard, you know, they would be standard. So that's why we don't use a lot of weight for one. And then just because we're probably gonna just do one set. I just didn't feel like changing out the weights. I just want you to see what it is, because it does work. I mean, it works good for your forearms. You can feel it. And it does kind of the opposite side of what we were just doing with the reverse curls. And that's what we want. We want to hit both, you know, all the parts of the muscle. So, all right, let's knock out 10 of these, and hopefully you can see what I'm doing. So I went a little bit lighter on the weight than what I was expecting. So I went ahead and just did 20 reps. And hopefully that from that angle, you could see what I was doing. If you're bigger like we are, like I am, it's gonna hit your backside. So that's why I said it's kind of a weird movement. You've got the bar kind of rolling up your backside, but you're not supporting it with anything. I mean, you're just using your forearms. It's not like your glutes can pick that bar up. So. Don't be worried if it's touching you or touching your lower back or your buttock area, because it's not doing anything. The weight's only going up and down from your forearms, and it really helps isolate. So like I said, it wasn't that much weight, and so I just went ahead and knocked it out for 20. And all right, I think it's time to move on to triceps. All right guys, so the next thing we're gonna do is tricep pushdowns with a rope. Hopefully you don't have to spend 5 minutes like I just did looking for the rope. Now, unfortunately, there was a single grip handle on this machine when I walked up to it. So I put on pretty low weight, and I tried to pull down with this left arm, and it felt pretty bad. So I've got super low weight on here, just 40 pounds. I'm probably not gonna get much out of this arm. So it'll just be basically this one arm pulling it down, but I'm gonna try to maybe rehab it a little bit. Just hold on for dear life with this one. So I'm gonna shoot for 20, and hopefully we get there. Alright guys, so that didn't feel too bad. My right arm is doing most of the work. I bumped it up to 50 pounds, and that's still probably just gonna be this arm doing most of the work. As you can see, you know, that's where I would normally be on each arm. So we'd be doing probably 80 pounds, 90 pounds, 100 pounds, somewhere in there. But I mean, try to do the same thing with this one. And I mean, just shooting pain. So I'm gonna try my best. We're gonna do 50 pounds and try to get that for 20 again at least. So, all right. All right guys, so we just did that set. I'm probably done with that part of it. I'm gonna show you one or two more things on triceps, but still, elbow is not there yet. So I'm just gonna use my right hand. All I've done is I've taken the rope and I've just pulled it through. So just one long rope. That let me grip right here. and do some single arm pushdowns. I like them because they kind of mimic doing dips, right? Because it's about the same height that you'd be doing dips. Obviously at 370 pounds, I can't do bodyweight dips yet. This gym doesn't have an assisted dip machine. If your gym has one, use it. You'd be surprised at the gains you can make doing bodyweight dips. Now, if you have the assisted machine, like I said, the last gym I used to go to, it had one. And don't get me wrong, when I first started out, I was having to put it on like 120 pounds, 150 pounds, whatever it was, to where it was taking that away from my body weight. It was assisting me by 150 pounds. So, you know, I'm a skinny guy when you take 150 pounds off of me. But then I worked my way down, and by when I quit going to that gym, I think I was only getting maybe 70 pounds of assistance. So that's a big difference, and it works pretty good. But on this exercise, like I said, it's kind of like a dip, straight down. You really want to focus on getting contraction here, and that's all you're looking for, because there's not a lot of resistance in right in here, because this is stopped. So it's really about going all the way down, getting that contraction at the bottom. Now, I'm not using a lot of weight because I just wanted you to see, I think we're on 30 pounds, but I wanted you to kind of see this exercise so you kind of had an idea as to how it worked. And normally, I'll turn around and do that on this side the same. It doesn't feel too bad, but I'm not really able to stretch out enough to get a good contraction because my arm's not going fully straight. And part of that might be because I got the brace. As you can see, this arm goes straight, this arm's kind of crooked. So, anyways, I think that's going to do it for our arm workout today. I'm sorry I couldn't show you more stuff on triceps. I really am. I'm sorry for myself, too, that I couldn't get some more stuff done. It just needs some more time to heal up. I hope you got a lot from the bicep workout. Those are some of my favorite bicep exercises. There's a ton. And I'll keep showing you stuff. I'll keep showing you other bicep exercises because I know a whole bunch of them. And they all work different parts of the bicep, and they all feel good, and they all burn. And like I said at the beginning of the video, I like to do arms, forearms, biceps, triceps, because it's one of the first things you can really see. You could come in here every day, and you could do, sorry about that, I could come in here every day and do 100 crunches, and it's going to be a long time, if ever, before I see abs. But you come in, you work your arms hard, a couple weeks, you'll start seeing noticeable changes, and you'll feel them as well. So, hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you guys are keeping with the diet. Hope you're watching the other videos because it's meal prepping. We finally got the breakfast video. Oh, and if you're wondering what happened to the leg video, when I was uploading it, like the whole thing was done and I was uploading it, I deleted it. So we're just going to have to wait till the next round of legs, which will be sometime next week. But I will get you a leg video as well. Probably back on the next video, then probably chest, and then legs, and then the process will kind of start over. I'm going to show you different stuff on each one. I mean, it's not just going to be me doing the same thing each time. I'm going to try to switch it up, so, you know, for my own benefit, but also for you guys as well. Muscle confusion, that's a word that gets tossed around a lot, but it really does work. Because if you just keep training the same way all the time, you're not growing, and you're not tearing down all the different muscle fibers. So you want to try different things. Really, you don't want to even do the same type of workout for more than about 6 weeks. You want to completely adjust it and change it about every 6 weeks. But early on, just get in here and do the work. That's all that really matters. So hope you liked this video. If you did, hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We have gotten a lot of support, and I do appreciate that in a short amount of time. Check out the Instagram. I think on the last video I said it wrong, but it's Bolton Fat to Fit. I think I said Fit to Fat. Positive thinking. I was already fit and then I got fat, but no, it's Bolton Fat to Fit on Instagram. Same thing with the email. It's boltonfattofit@gmail.com. Shoot me some questions. I saw another guy, I said, check out my Instagram. I told you if there was somebody else out there doing kind of something like I'm doing, that I'd give him a shout out. And unfortunately, I didn't write down his Instagram, but he's on my Instagram. He's one of my followers, so you can check him out. I think the guy's about 450 pounds. and he's putting in the work. He's already, it seems like he's only maybe weighing himself maybe every quarter, which is amazing, because that would be an amazing feeling. I'm a little bit too obsessive. I jump on that scale almost every day, but sometimes twice a day. But yeah, it looks like he's probably down 50 pounds, 70 pounds already, something like that, and just started. So just started, maybe looks like February or something like that. So give a shout out to him, and I'll get his information. And yeah, seemed like a cool guy. So all right, guys. Well, again, hope you enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe to the channel. Check us out on Instagram. And if you got any questions, shoot me a DM or an email. And we'll see you on the next workout. And all right, guys. God bless.